everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and you're tuned.
We're at the oldest continually operating stadium in the NFL as you get a look inside Lambeau Field in Green Bay. Nothing on the scoreboard, 0-0, as the offense gets ready to take over the football. First carry for Christian McCaffrey, and he'll find some space up to about the 25. The numbers for McCaffrey last week, 16 carries, 78 yards.
They've won two straight games and have done it with the running game as the focal point of their offense. So in this contest, I don't think about doing anything else. I continue to ride the hot hand that I've established and lead with the runners.
Back to throw, Newton. Forced out to his left. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clear shot on him. Plus, he moves it a lot faster than what people think. And boy, does he have fun playing the game of football.
And he takes this up right near the 45-yard line. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave him with a second and two. If these kinds of lanes are available, you have to feel like he's going to have a pretty big game on the ground.
Yeah, you can tell early on he's got a little burst in his step, and that's a big pickup right there on first down.
And an alley to run. And he'll get it down to the 47 here. It's an 8-yard pickup and leads to a new set of downs.
Looks like they're establishing a pretty good pattern here because they've been very heavy in the running game on the last four plays.
Yeah, you took the words right out of my mouth. So far, four plays in this drive, all four on the ground. They go play action here on first down. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down.
Well, there's your first ROI, right? Return on investment of their first-round pick. His first NFL sack, I know they want him to be an impact player right out of the gate.
A lot of pressure to put on a young man, but I think you agree he has the ability to deliver on it.
And he just did, probably the first of many sacks in a long career.
He's going to launch this thing way down. That's caught inside the 20. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. And that one results in 35 yards.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there for a big gainer, that's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. If you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
This is Newton off the play fake to McCaffrey. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. This offense ready to head back out there as they'll take over with a little over a minute to play in this first quarter. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Here's Newton now on second down. And the Packers give him nowhere to go, and they bring him down. Mike Daniels in there to sack him for a loss of six. Well, it was second long. Now it's third and even longer. They're going in the wrong direction here.
Because they're moving exactly the way they want to, but you're exactly right. Definitely going in the wrong direction for the offensive guys.
And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down. So possession one ended in six. Possession two likely going to end in a punt.
And that's okay. They just got to get back to what they worked on in the opening drive and continue to make a few adjustments along the way. It won't be exact because the defense will make a few adjustments themselves. Just get back to your game plan.
taken from just outside the 30. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Packer football here. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. And the Panthers coming out now. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet. And
he's got a man complete. Give him 30 yards there. We often, with Cam Newton, talk a lot about his legs. Don't forget about that arm.
He can throw it on a rope. He can loft it. He's got the touch that's been developed throughout his career. But the big part about just watching him throw it, it seems almost effortless.
And he's going to get stopped up quickly. Give him a yard down to the 43.
Well, that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive. And once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. And he'll be brought down at about the 42. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far. And after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going. And really, the offensive line not helping him much. Here's Newton. Got his target, Samuel. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. These fifth-rounders, and to use him as an example, maybe you take a little bit of a flyer on someone, hope you hit gold.
Exactly, because when you get into the fifth round, you're usually not counting on him to become a starter right away, but we've seen so many times, fifth, sixth, seventh, undrafted free agents who come in and make their way, and in a big way.
Really, it's a solid draft class from a year ago. They were able to address some key weak spots on their team and fill in some holes.
And they were able to identify the players they wanted early in the process. Got a little bit of luck, as some guys may have fallen to them. But for the most part, knew their philosophy and stuck to it.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. Second down is Newton. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner. We pick it up second quarter here as the offense gets ready for the drive. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That one goes for 24 yards. And defensively, they were in zone coverage there. Do you have to be a little careful you're losing playing against a good quarterback like he is to not play too much zone?
Yeah, you have to be careful about how much time you're giving up. I think it's
and no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Montrevious Adams busting through to get him for a loss of 6. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Sad. Quarterback gets hit.
Now a play fake, and it's Newton. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down.
It's a lot of contact going on there. And in the end, unable to keep two hands on the football and bring it into his body.
Everything looked pretty good until the finish. They'll fake the handoff. Now Newton. A minute 57 to go in this first half. We're back to Lambeau following these words. Here's the Panthers punter now. On for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first.
Hey!
He gets it away. It's a high hanger. And this one will not be returnable as it sails out of bounds. And taking a gander at the NFL scoreboard in Minneapolis. And the Lions have opened it up, leading now by a couple of touchdowns. We'll keep you updated on that one as it progresses. Now the Panthers offense, they get set to come back onto the field. Down to the 25. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Well, he's looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it, because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
On second down, here's Newton. His throw caught at about the 5. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as the clock will stop with 18 seconds to go in the first half. So now it's first and goal. They come out here in the eye. Here's Newton. And he's got it. Touchdown, Panthers. This offense ready to get back out there as they'll have the football to start the third quarter. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Now a handoff here to his running back. And some big-time hitting going on there. He is knocked to the ground right around the 26.
It's real easy to say this running game needs to be better, but the reality is they've been given little time to actually find a place to run the football. It's almost like the defense is there on the handoff.
The Panthers on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. Off play action, Newton. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there. If he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback that has to slide and find open space to throw. Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things, but the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blows. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Whatever the discussions were at halftime to try to slow down this offense, it has not worked to this point.
Yeah, I have a vision right now of everything that was discussed at the half just being torn in shreds or being erased off of the Microsoft Surface tablets, because none of it is working. They are really locked in on offense.
Working his way for a gain of 7 to the 26.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
To throw on second down, Newton. This will be caught inside the 10. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
An ex-teammate used to tell me all the time, I hate experienced quarterbacks, because no matter what, you really can't hide what you're doing. And I think that right there, he knew right away where the blitz was coming from, where his primary guy was going to be, and he ended up going to a secondary target for a nice game.
I was just
going to
ask you, that wasn't the primary target. He's got it for a Panther touchdown. Third quarter action, and this offense will have a first and 10 as they get set for the next drive. And onto the field, here come the Panthers. They are clicking on all cylinders. They seem to be just scoring at will right now, and that's why they've opened up this big lead.
Now, we always talk about getting into the zone, and all athletes are seeking that, aren't they? Where everything is working for them, every move they make works, it clicks, and they are on point right now.
Yeah, they are in that zone that you're talking about. A big hit. Knocked down sideways. 4 yards there on the carry, gets it back to second and 11.
Third quarter, and you've got the lead. You're not ready to go into that four-minute offense to close the game out. But a running game can really benefit your team right now.
On second down, they'll try and run the counter. And he'll take this forward for 2, maybe 3. But we do have a flag down, and they're already marching backward. So on the big tight end, holding.
Each and every year, we talk about very few tight ends coming into the league that are polished blockers or asked to do it a lot in college. So it's a constant struggle and a constant fight to learn how to do it without holding.
Looking to throw on second down. Newton, he's going to go for a big play downfield. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. So the contact came before the ball got there, and the flag is thrown.
Timing is everything, isn't it? And it's so hard to cover these great receivers. They have such great body control, and they can fake you out. In this case, as you described, got there before the ball got to the receiver. Penalty flag had to come out.
Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9. See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll muscle his way up to the 43 for a pickup of right around 5.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here. A little antsy on the left side of the line.
Yeah, I think they got the guy in the end. I think they got the DN there on that one. And let's face it, he is so amped up, wanting to get a good get off on the snap. Jump too quickly.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom. Quick, and what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
And nowhere really to go there. He'll take this up just shy of midfield. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves him needing a conversion here on 3rd and a tough 9.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive, and like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game, and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, 3rd quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. And Green Bay getting ready to go as they take the field. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Sense of urgency.
It'll be a 1st and 10 coming up as this offense takes over possession of the football in the 3rd quarter. Gonna give this time to the tailback. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. A great effort there. His 3rd touchdown. checking things elsewhere. Third quarter now from U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. And the Lions adding more points to their total, extending that lead. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. So they pick up the first down after the run, and now they approach for the fresh set. Now a handoff looking right. And some room to run now. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. That one good for 33 and a first.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 12 more yards there and another first down.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run, got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And he'll get about three as he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
Now, I can't imagine any celebrations being any bigger than your first NFL touchdown. And this rookie running back is still seeking his. He's not going to get it on that play.
Time running out here on the play clock. And he'll give it here to his running back. And effective running here. He'll take it down inside the 10. The Panthers on third down. 2 for 5 to this point. They need just a yard here. It's third and one. Now they'll run it on the toss. And he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. They only got 2, but that was enough as they'll convert to make it first and goal.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion. And that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. Call it a loss of 2 on the play. And that'll bring up a second and goal.
Brent, it's clearly a running situation when you're up in the fourth quarter. They're going to have to stack the box and make it difficult for them to move the ball.
Made it very difficult right there. Now they need to repeat that effort.
Yeah, bring 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take to slow them down.
And he'll be stopped up after only a couple of yards as he gets it down to the 5.
Well, Brandon, we always know that once you score one touchdown,
you want 2.
You're without a doubt. And so far today, he's got 1, but was denied as he tried to get the second one.
This offense so far on third down, they've hit at 50%, 3 of 6 to this point. This is third and goal. And he takes it into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. It's the fullback, his first touchdown. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They run the counter now on first down, and he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all 3 still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage. Use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the 2-minute warning. A handoff as they run the counter play. And for one of the few times here today, this run's not going to go anywhere. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. On 3rd down, they'll try and pick it up with a counter. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up a fourth down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. Checking the NFL scoreboard there in the fourth now in Minneapolis. Well, their defense did the job. They got the turnover on downs. Now what can the offense do as they take possession? Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field.
And this game comfortably in hand. The scoreboard speaks for itself, but you still got your starting quarterback out there. When do you go to the backup? Let him get some time.
And that's one of the great questions in the NFL, Brandon, because I'm just going to tell you, in the 2015 season, I commentated on three games in a row that were blowouts. And in none of them did the starting quarterback ever come out of the game for the team that had a big lead. And in each instance, I asked the coaches later on, why didn't you do that? And they all looked at me and said, just don't really do that in the NFL. You know, these guys.
I'm